Today we're going to be looking at third-party keyboards so that when you check out an iPad from the Special Ed Tech Center, you'll know how to access the third-party keyboards. When you check out an iPad, these are the third-party keyboards that should be on the iPad. So Keedogo Plus, Keedogo, Superkeys, Keeble, and then the co-writer third-party keyboard. When I first download a third-party keyboard from iTunes, so I purchase the keyboard, it shows up on my iPad as an app icon, so it looks very similar to any other app you download. But when you tap on the icon, you're not going to have access to the actual keyboard at that point. You're going to be getting some information about the keyboard, maybe how to customize it, some settings within the iPad, the third-party keyboard, because some of them have settings, but you're not going to have access to the actual keyboard at that point. The way in which you access the third-party keyboards is to go into Settings and then tap on Keyboards. And again, tap on Keyboards. You see that next to Keyboards it has the number 1, meaning you have one keyboard available. At this point, you can add a new keyboard. And here you see that you have third-party keyboards available to you. What we want to do is select them so that they move to the top with the other keyboard that's available. So I'll add a new keyboard, tap on Superkeys, and it goes to the top. There are some keyboards that you're going to add. So say Keeble, for instance. It's going to take me to a screen where I need to select the language, the type of keyboard. So I'm going to tap on English US and say done. And same with the next two, Keedogo. I have to select English US, and same with Keedogo Plus. And the reason that the keyboards, when I say add a new keyboard, the reason that these keyboards are still available under third-party keyboards is because I could technically add more than one type of Keedogo keyboard. I could choose a different language if I needed that. But I think we're set. So we have access to all of these keyboards now. So I'm going to go ahead and open up Notes, and right away it's going to a different keyboard. You notice that's very different than the standard keyboard. The standard keyboard will still be available to me, but I now can use different types of keyboards. You see the globe on the bottom row, left-hand side? I'm going to hold that down, and when I hold that down, I see all of the third-party keyboards available to me. If I simply tap on it, it will just scroll through the keyboards, and then I can stop on the one that I like. So I have my English keyboard. Let's go to the co-writer keyboard and tap on that. Now the co-writer keyboard is the only one of these keyboards where you will need to be initially signing in, because when you have a subscription to Co-Writer Universal, you have access to then this keyboard. So if you are wanting to test it out, you may need to be doing a 30-day trial and be testing it out that way. The unique thing about the Co-Writer keyboard is the access to their robust word prediction and also their topic dictionaries. So as I start to type, you see that I have access to the word prediction. If I want access to the topic dictionaries, I would tap on the book that was at the bottom row. We'll look at that again in a moment. And I could either search for a topic that the student's going to be writing about, or select one that's available if it's applicable. And that will allow the word prediction to predict words from a dictionary that houses the content words from that topic. I can say done if I have the correct topic dictionary selected. And now when I start to type, say, Abraham Lincoln, that's going to come up quickly. So Co-Writer was created for students with some motor difficulties to help speed them up so they didn't have to type out every letter, but is also used by students with learning disabilities who struggle with the full spelling of words. So you have this third-party keyboard available. Now this one is also unique in that you don't see the globe in order to change from one keyboard to another. But if I hold down my finger on the topic dictionary button, so the button with, or the cell with the books, then my globe's gonna pop up and I can go ahead and tap on the globe. It has moved me to the Keedogo Plus keyboard. How would I know that? I could hold down my finger on the globe and see that Keedogo Plus is highlighted. And with this keyboard, you see that it's a different type of font that may be easier for students to see. There's color-coded cells to direct them to the cells. And there's the word prediction across the top. And there's some customizability within this app as far as colors. Here we're back at the standard keyboard, so you still have access to the standard iPad keyboard. I'm going to hold down that globe button and let's go and look at Keedogo. We looked at Keedogo Plus, let's look at Keedogo. So here we have those bright yellow cells, the high contrast for students who may struggle visually with the layouts of keyboards, and a kind of a simplified look. You do not have the word prediction, but you do have those color-coded cells. Let's take a look at Superkeys. Here you definitely have a keyboard that is designed for students with motor difficulties because they do not have to have really refined motor skills to activate these cells. If I wanted to type the word the, I would tap on the middle upper cell and it pops those keys out to me. If I was starting at the beginning of a sentence, let's just go back. Now you'll notice that when I selected the cell, it didn't pop back to the other cells that I initially had. It stays on the cell area that I selected, but I could start to type a word. I'm tapping on the upper right-hand cell, pops those letters out to me, and type the letter I want. You have the word prediction, so if I want the word open, I would just tap on open. And that is Superkeys for you. To find out if any of these keyboards are able to be customized, again, you can go ahead and look within the app. So I'll click on Superkeys, and you'll see that there's now some settings in Superkeys. So let's see what those are. Settings, it looks like I can change some of the appearance, some of the color and such. So that's where you'd find out how customizable your keyboard is. I think there was one keyboard we didn't look at yet, and that's Keeble. And that's going to be your most customizable keyboard available. And let's just see what it looks like. I have to scroll through the different keyboards to get to it, but we will get there. When you're trying keyboards out with students, you might want to only make a couple available so you're not having to scroll through different ones or have too many options. You're just wanting to see if a particular keyboard is helpful. So this one's Keeble. We're not going to go into all the features as far as the customizability. That will be a different tutorial, but you can see the simplified layout and just know that this one is going to be more expensive because there's a lot more opportunity for customizing the keyboard for the student. And that's it. We'll look into other third-party keyboards in another tutorial.